All right, hi guys. If you are watching this video, then you are trying to prepare for the test tomorrow, which is on finding the area of a triangle. Before we start, as a review, area is how much space something takes up. And we know that for a rectangle or a square that we do the length times the width to figure out how much is in there. And that when we're trying to find the area of a triangle, we have to do half of the length times the width because the triangle is half of a rectangle. And we are only trying to find half of that, so we can just cut it in half. I'm going to quickly review some basics and then get into some harder problems. So we have the triangle here. I sometimes like to just shade it in just so I can see that this is what I'm trying to find, the area of that. And again, I have to find that this one's just asking for the base and for the height. Well, if they're telling me the height is this one, I would put W, V, and I would put a line over it, because that's a line. And I have to find the base. Remember, the base has to be a 90 degrees to the height. It can't be YU because that is not a 90 degree angle. I can see on the corner of W that there's a right angle sign, so I know the base has to be this. Some people are going to want to say WU, and that is not the correct answer because just by looking at what I've shaded, this part is not part of the actual triangle. This would have to be the base. They just extended it so it would make a 90 degree angle, so my base would be TU. Over here, we've got a bunch of lines, and they're telling me that the base is B to C. So I know that because it's labeled. But I know that if this is the base, then the height has to make a 90 degree angle with the opposite tallest point. And I know that it has to match with A. So looking here from a perpendicular line that goes up, this can't be BY because that's not perpendicular. It can't be XC because that's not perpendicular. It has to be this line right here. So the height would have to be A to Z. You could also do ZA and CB. It doesn't matter the order as long as you have it. All right, now this just wants us to find the overall area of this. As a review, I'm not trying to find the area of the whole thing. I just want to find the area of this right here. So at the bottom, this part says the whole thing is 70, so I know this whole side is 70. But I know that this part is 32, so I'm going to get rid of that to see what is left. So I'm doing 70 minus 32, I'm going to get 38. So I know that this has to be 32. And I'm going to say my base is 32 feet, okay? Now I have to find my height. I know that the height has to reach the top opposite point, and I know that it has to be 90 degrees. I know that this can't be the height because it's not 90, and this can't be the height. What I'm going to do is extend it out, and then this meets with that point. So the height has to be 45 feet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply my base times my height, and I'm going to do 32 times 45, and I'm going to get 1,440. So that would be the whole thing. I don't want that. I only want the triangle, so I'm going to do half of that. So I'm going to divide that by 2, and I'm going to get 720. And remember my label, because area is something squared, because we're actually finding how many squares are in it. So 720 feet squared. All right, this one, they want us to find the area of these two. Again, I'm trying to find the base and the height. There's three numbers here. I'm not going to need them. I have to find if this is the base. Like, say I think 5 is the base. Well, it can't be because 7 can't be the height because this is not a right angle. So it can't be that. I could say maybe 7 is the base. If I say 7 is the base, because remember, I'm trying to find this triangle, then 5 can't be the height because this is not perpendicular. So as you can see, they have extended the triangle, and then this is my height. So I'm going to do height, and I'm going to multiply them by each other, and then I get 28. As a reminder, 28 is for like the square, and we want half of that. So I'm going to do 14 inches squared is my area. Over here is a similar one where they're giving us 1, 2, 3. They give us 4 numbers. Now looking at this, the dotted lines is not part of the triangle. So here is my actual triangle. I'm going to do the base times the height. Maybe I think that this is the base, but it can't be because this isn't perpendicular. This can't be the base because nothing is perpendicular. So, after I cancel some things out, I'm going to say that this is the base. Well, the 20 inches goes from here to here. I'm going to get rid of that 6 to see like what is left for over this side. So this side's 14. So I'm going to say my base is 14. That's my base. My height has to reach up to this tallest point, but it has to make a 90 degree angle. So I'm gonna extend it out. This has to be my height.
So I'm going to multiply 14 times 15, and I end up getting 210 inches. Now remember, I want half of that, so I'm going to divide that by 2, and I get 105 inches squared. Okay? Guys, really make sure you check the label. Some of you guys, like, it says inches here, and then for some reason you write centimeters in your answer. You're going to lose points for that. If you don't put it squared, you're going to lose points for that. That is not correct. You have to make sure you have the correct label. All right, ABCD is a square of side 10 centimeters, and BE equals EC. So here's 10, BE and EC are the same. Well, if this is 10, it's a square. I know that this is also 10, and this is half of it. So this has to be 5, and this has to be 5, because 5 plus 5 is 10. They want me to find the area of the shaded triangle. This is not shaded well on my board, but this is the shaded triangle, okay? So what I'm going to have to do is multiply my base times my height. So I'm looking at this, and I'm going to say that the base of this is BE, and the base is 5 centimeters, okay? I know the height has to reach to this point, but it also has to make a 90-degree angle. Realistically, I would extend it, and this would be my height. And because this is a square, if this side's 10, I know that this side is also 10. So I'm going to multiply 10 times 5 to get 50 centimeters squared. That would be the area of the whole thing, but I don't want that. I only want half of that. So I'm going to split it in half, and I get 25 centimeters squared. Okay? Next one I'm going to do is ABCD is a rectangle, 18 by 8 centimeters. So there's my 18, and here's my 8. Find the AE equals ED. Here's what I'm going to find. Hang on. A to E equals E to D. And AF equals FB. So there's my little dashes. Okay, so again, if this side's 8, I know that this whole side has to be 8. And these two are half of that, so this has to be 4, and this has to be 4. If I know this side's 18, I know this side has to be 18, and half of 18 is 9. So this side is 9, and this side is 9. Okay? Now I want to find the area of the shaded triangle. So what I'm going to do is I have the base is right here, I'm going to say, and that is 4. And then I know the height has to come up to this point, but it has to be a 90-degree angle. So it can't be that, and it can't be that. I'm going to extend it out. And then this ends up being my height. And then my height ends up being 9 centimeters. Okay? And then I'm going to multiply them together. And I get 36 centimeters squared. But again, because it's a triangle, I need half of that. And I end up getting 18. And I check my label, centimeters squared. Okay? All right, let's do another. ABCD is a rectangle of area 48 square inches. So I'm going to stop. They're telling me the area of this whole entire thing is 48. And that whole thing's a rectangle, so I know that whatever the width is and whatever the length is, I can multiply them together to get to 48. So this times this side has to be 48. It says the length of CD, CD, so the length of this, is 3 times the length of DF. 3 times that. Okay? BC equals 4 inches. B to C is 4. Find the length of DF. Okay, well, first of all, if I know my width is 4, I know that 4 times what would get me to be 48. So in my calculator, I could do 48 divided by 4. Or you just know the math back in your head, and you know that the length has to be 12. Find out the length is 12, and I know that DF, that CD is 3 times, each of these are 3 times, DF is a third of CD, then I know that each of these has to be 4, because 4 times 3 is 12, okay? So 4, 4, 4, and the sides are also 4. It says find the length of DF. Okay, we already did that. D to F, on my answer sheet, I would write line DF equals 4 inches. Some of you guys are putting squared, and that's not correct because it doesn't say find the area. It says find the length, okay? Then B says, find the area of the shaded triangle. Well, again, I'm trying to find the base and the height. The base is going to be 4. And then my height has to meet up to this point, but it has to be a 90-degree angle. Realistically, I know that it's this line, and if this line's 4, then this line also has to be 4. So the height is 4 inches. If I multiply them together, I get 16 inches squared, and I know that I have to divide that in 2 because it is half of what it has to be. And 16 divided by 2 is 8 inches squared. Double check, did I write things? Yes, inches. Okay. All right, we're going to do another one. The perimeter of rectangle, if you want to pause it, you can, and solve it on your own. The perimeter of ABCD is 256. I know that that means side plus side plus side plus side is 256 inches because it says perimeter. Its length is 3 times its width. I'm going to split this up so I know that this has 3 because it's 3 times its width. Okay? So total, I would have a line here. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means that all of these little sides together are exactly the same, and they all, there's 8 of them. So I'm going to take my total perimeter, and I'm going to divide that by 8. And then I end up with 32. So that means that each of these is 32 all the way around. Okay? I have to even look. This is the shaded. As a reminder to myself. Find the area of triangle ABC. Again, I have to find the base now, and I have to find the height. I'm going to say the base is BC, and I know that I have 32, and I have 3 of them, so I'm going to do 32 times 3, and that this whole base is 96, and it is inches. Now I need to do the height. It has to meet at a 90-degree angle to the opposite point, so I know the height is right here, which is 32 inches. I'm going to multiply them together, 96 times 32, and I get 3,072, but I know I only need half of that, so I'm going to divide that by 2, and I get 1,536 inches squared. Okay? I think we have, this is our last one. The side of square ABCD is 8. Okay, so each side, it's a square, so I know all the sides are 8. And this is what I shaded in part. AE equals AF, which equals 4. So this is 4, and this is also 4. So this has to be 4 and all the way around, okay? Find the area of the shaded triangle CEF. This one's a little tricky because a lot of us were trying to figure out this line, and we were having trouble actually figuring that out. My suggestion would be to find, if this is a square, I can find the area of the whole entire thing. So if I want to find the area of the whole thing, I can do 8 times 8, so the area of this square, and that equals 64 centimeters squared. I'm checking my labels, okay? And then what I thought is I could take out, if I can't figure out what FE is, I could take out the things, the unknowns, and take them away, and whatever's left has to be CEF. This reminds me of when we did area and perimeter, and we had to do this in chapter 12 of the fourth grade book, where we took away what we could and left what we didn't know. So I'm going to actually do that. I'm going to find the area of this triangle first. So if the base is 8 and the height is 4, because this is half of 8, I know that 8 times 4 is 32, and then I have to split it in half. So I know that this is 16. This one, the base, I could say the base is 4, or I could say the base is 8, it doesn't matter. Let's go with 4. The base is 4, and the height would be right here, and that's 8. Again, 4 times 8 is 32. Half of that is 16. Then this last one, if the base is 4, then the height right here is also 4. 4 times 4 is 16, and half of that is 8. So I'm going to get rid of these numbers and take it away until I have that triangle left. So if I take 16 plus 16 plus 8, and I add them together, and then I'm going to get rid of them. X it out, and X it out. Well, if I'm Xing it out, I'm subtracting. So I'm going to take the whole entire square, which is 64 centimeters squared, and I'm going to take the 40 centimeters that I don't need, and I subtract it, I'm left with 24 centimeters squared. And I end up getting what that shaded triangle is. So CEF would be 24 centimeters squared. All right, here's our very last one. ABCD is a rectangle, 12 centimeters by 5 centimeters. BE equals 4. Find the area of the shaded region. Now here's the thing. This isn't a triangle. So you could do this two ways. You could find the area of the whole entire thing. So the area of the whole thing is 12 times 5. And so if I did 12 times 5 and I found the area of the whole thing, I could get rid of, again, what I don't need, which would be this. I don't need that. So that's for the whole rectangle. If I want to find the little triangle, I could do the base, which is 5, times the height. So the base equals 5, and the height, well, if this whole side's 12, this whole side's 12. And if that's 4, then this has to be 8. And I know that 5 times 8 is 40, divided by 2 would be 20 centimeters. And then if I got rid of it and I did 60, the whole thing, minus the 20 I don't need, I would end up with 40 centimeters squared. Or I could do it a different way. I could take this, which some of you did, is you realize that this, you can split it up. And you have a shape here, and you have a shape here, and you can find both of them. So I'm going to find this rectangle first. I know that I have to do length times width. So 4 times 5, this would be 20 centimeters. Then for this one, I could do the base times the height. So I'm going to say the base of this is, or maybe I'll say that this is the base. I know that that is 5, and I know the height has to be a 90-degree angle, and that is 8. And 5 times 8 is 40, divided by 2. Is 20, and then I can put these two together, and 20 plus 20 would still get me these 40 centimeters squared. So if you ever get confused on the test, maybe try to think of it the opposite way of what you've been doing. Instead of trying to find the triangle, maybe find what you don't need and then take it away from the whole. So it depends on how you're looking at it. Hopefully this video was helpful. There's another one that you can watch too that reviews a little bit more of the basics of area of a triangle, and I hope that you are ready for the test tomorrow. All right, bye guys.